Do you understand what you are undertaking? All right, godparents. This is Mike and Stephanie. It's going to be a popular name. Are you willing to help the parents of this child in their duties as Christian parents? Okay. And so, Brian, the Christian community welcomes you with great joy, and in its name I claim you for Christ, our Savior, by the sign of his cross. I trace it on his forehead, and I invite everyone else to do the same. Yeah? Come on up. Come on over. Okay, our first reading today is going to be back on page 27. Okay. It's Paul's letter to the Romans. It's the first New Testament reading on page 27. Are you not aware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Through baptism into his death, we were buried with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. If we have been united with him through a likeness to his death, so shall we be through a life of resurrection. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our response is on page 28. The Lord is my life and my salvation. Repeat. The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge, of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
One thing I ask of the Lord, and this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Your presence, O Lord, I seek, hide not your face from me. Do not in anger repel your servant. You are my helper, cast me not off. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage, be stout-hearted, and wait for the Lord. The Lord be with you. Please stand. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Glory to you. Back on page 4. Jesus came forward and addressed the 11 disciples in these words. Full authority has been given to me both in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Teach them to carry out everything that I have commanded you, and know that I am with you always until the end of the world. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today we welcome in Brian to our fold. We also, through his baptism, reminisce on ours and how the priests conducted our own baptism, because baptisms haven't changed in over 1,500 years in our nation. letter from Paul to the Romans, this particular reading is also read at funeral readings. And that's why I wanted to try to make the correlation between baptism and also our funeral liturgies. Because of the fact that we welcome Brian to a new life of Christ as he comes into this world, so too in the funeral liturgy, we welcome or we pray for that person who is in heaven and who starts off a new life with God in heaven. And so that's why the baptism is really a baptism into the death of Christ, because we have to die in order to rise again in the hope of the resurrection. So too, Brian will learn that from his parents and through our own examples of the faith, that he, like our responsorial song says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. And whom should I fear? The Lord is my life refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?" And that's really why I think it's appropriate for us today on the Feast of Pentecost to welcome in Brian to the church. Because it is that spirit that, of the Lord that really was given to the apostles at Pentecost that is given to Brian in this sacrament of baptism and will be reconfirmed with him in confirmation. That same spirit that permeates all of us and brings us to a new life of God in heaven. We understand that life for us changes as we look through the eyes of a Christian. For the passion, death, and resurrection experience of Jesus is always in all the forefronts. As in, when in fact we fail to communicate and we have an argument, that becomes for us a death experience, sort of. And yet, through the sacrament of reconciliation, talking things out between two people, we gain enough more understanding of that person and what that person is all about. And so, again, a resurrection experience happens for us in the church. And so this is why, for Brian, it's going to be important for him to be able to understand that in his life, and also through the examples of parents now participating in the Eucharist and coming to church, that he will again be able to be brought to the glories of God through the sacramental life of the church. With his baptism, Holy Communion, the rite of reconciliation, confirmation, and maybe here, or maybe he would be fully open. We might need him someday, the church. So, my dear friends, let us ask the Lord then, Jesus Christ, to look lovingly on this child as he wants to be baptized, on his parents and godparents, and on all the baptized. By the mystery of your death and resurrection, make this child in life. Give him a new life in baptism, and welcome him into your holy church. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Through baptism and confirmation, make him your faithful follower and a witness to your gospel, we pray to the Lord. Part of our raising ritual is the fact that we call upon the angels and saints to be with us, to be with Brian as he begins his new life of faith with us. And so we pray, Holy Mary, Mother of God, St. John the Baptist, St. Joseph, St. Peter, and St. Paul, St. Andrew, and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Oh my gosh. It's going to be at the time when I pour water on them. It's going to start crying. It's usually before then. Matt?
The celebration of the sacrament, if I can invite the parents and godparents up. Go around. My dear brothers and sisters, we now ask God to give this child new life and abundance through water and the Holy Spirit.
Bring me as far back as you can
so
without
going to the blessings of this font. Father, you have given us grace through the sacramental life and the signs in which you tell us of the wonders of your unseen power. In baptism, you use the gift of water which you made a rich symbol of the grace you give us in this sacrament. At the very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathed from the waters, making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood you made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end to sin and a new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan your son was baptized by St. John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Your son willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. After his resurrection he told his disciples, "Go out and teach all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Father, look now with love upon your church, and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. By the power of the Spirit, give the waters of this font the grace of your Son. You created man in your own likeness, cleanse him from sin, and the new birth of innocence by water and the Holy Spirit. We ask you, Father, then, with your Son, to send your Holy Spirit upon the waters of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism rise also with him to a newness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear parents and godparents, you have come here to present this child for baptism. By water and the Holy Spirit, he is to be receiving the gifts of the new life which God gives us in love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring him up to the practice of the faith. See that the divine life which God gives him is kept safe from the poison of sin and to grow always stronger in his heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism, reject sin, profess your faith in Jesus Christ. For this is the faith of the church. This is the faith in which Brian will be about to be baptized into. And so I ask you, parents and godparents, do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by it? The rest of you? Okay. Do you reject Satan, father of sin, and prince of darkness? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Now, is it your will that Brian should be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we have all professed with you? I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. This next anointing is an anointing with chrism. Chrism is a sacred oil in which we use in the church. It was used first by the prophets of the Old Testament, and the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon them, and they began to prophesy. And so it is that same spirit and the same consecrated oil in which we use on Brian this day. And if afterwards you'll be able to smell it. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin and given you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, welcomes you to his holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, may you always live as a member of his holy body, sharing everlasting life. Amen. Okay. And if you would, place the white garment on right now. Brian, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment an outward sign of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. He is to walk always as a child of the light. May he keep the flame of faith alive in his heart. When the Lord comes, may he go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, Brian. The Lord Jesus Christ made the deaf hear and the dumb speak. May he soon touch your ears to receive his word and your mouth to proclaim his faith to praise and glory of God the Father. Amen. If everyone could please stand. My dearly beloved, this child has been reborn in baptism. He is now called a child of God, and so indeed he is. In confirmation, he will receive the fullness of God's Spirit. In Holy Communion, he will share the banquet of Christ's sacrifice, calling God his Father in the midst of the church community. In the name of this child and in the spirit of our common sonship and daughtership, let us pray together the words our Lord has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Babe and mom's heart. Okay. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Our first blessing is for mother and child. God the Father, through his Son, Virgin Mother's Child, has brought joy to all Christian mothers as they see the hope of eternal life shine on in their children. May he bless the mother of his child. She now thanks God for the gift of her child. May she be one with him in thanking him forever in heaven, in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Our second blessing is for the Father. God is the giver of all life, human and divine. May he bless the father of this child. He and his wife will be the first of teachers of the child in the ways of faith. May they be also the best of teachers, bearing witness to the faith by what they say and do in Christ Jesus our Lord. And for us all, by God's gift through water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn to everlasting life. In his goodness, may he continue to pour out his blessings upon these sons and daughters of his. May he make them, wherever they may be, faithful members of his holy people. May he send his peace upon all who are gathered here in Christ Jesus our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This celebration is over. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please pass out your portraits.